Hello all. I, Chef Reena Dore, welcome you all once again to my channel Food Prod Notes. Today we are going to discuss about the artisan breads. This video is going to be in two parts. So in the first part, we are going to discuss about the definition and the various ingredients used in making the sourdough and the artisan breads. So how do you define artisan bread? It can be defined as homemade, handmade, made in small quantities, lacking in preservatives, and using traditional techniques. Also, a dictionary defines artisan as a skilled manual worker or a craftsperson. An artisan bread, thus, is one made by a skilled baker. Consumers' interest in flavorful and handmade breads has grown tremendously in recent years. This demand has led for research in artisan breads. The basic procedures which are required for producing conventional yeast breads applies still to the artisan breads. The principles and techniques which are used for making the commercial breads are holding true for artisan breads as well. But there are some additional complexities which are required while making the fine artisan breads. So, depending on our discussion, we can conclude that there are some characteristics of artisan breads. Some of the characteristics could be that it is handmade. So, this characteristic is most closely related to the dictionary definition of artisan. Thus, it necessarily means that artisan bread production is usually small scale and not high volume. Making artisan bread is not an automatic or purely mechanical process. Next characteristic could be use of pre-ferments and sourdough starters. A pre-ferment is a fermented dough or batter that is used to provide leavening for a larger batch of dough. A sourdough starter is similar to a yeast pre-ferment, except it uses wild yeast instead of commercial yeast. The next characteristic of an artisan bread is that non-usage of chemical additives or preservatives. The classic artisan bread is a crisp crusted bread that contains nothing but flour, water and salt. And it is leavened either by wild yeast, like in sourdough, or commercial yeast. Other ingredients may be added for some specialty breads, including dough ingredients such as milk, eggs, and butter, and add-ins such as herbs, spices, nuts, dried fruit, and olives. But all these ingredients should be recognizable by the consumer as familiar food items. And the next characteristic of an artisan bread is traditional production methods. Bread has been made for centuries without the use of any machinery, except of course ovens. And until recently, those ovens were wood-fired. Today's artisan bakers try to duplicate as much as possible these traditional methods. Since the fermentation process is important for flavor, the artisan bread doughs are usually fermented for longer times at lower temperatures, often without the use of proof boxes. Hearth ovens or deck ovens are invariably used, and some bakeries have even installed wood-fired hearth ovens for their breads. Now let's discuss the variety of ingredients used for making the artisan bread. In this category, first and foremost is the flour. As all the chefs know, choosing high quality ingredients is an important part of cooking the finest dishes. The same applies to bakery as well. Unless and until the finest quality flour is being used, the bread cannot be of that great quality. Most of the bakers use low protein content flours, which also means that the lower absorption ratio would be there in those flours. Low protein content flour are usually darker and has a higher ash content, resulting in fuller flavor. Also, the higher mineral content is beneficial to the long and slow fermentations, which is favored for artisan breads. Apart from wheat flour, some other flours can also be used while making the artisan breads, like rye flour or bran or the coarse flakes. Next, we would be discussing about the preferments and sourdough starters, which are very important in the production of artisan breads. Preferments give the fermentation a strong head start and they contribute to flavor by extending the fermentation period. In addition, the use of preferments allows the baker to reduce or eliminate the amount of commercial yeast used. And lastly, short fermentation straight doughs may be difficult to handle, requiring the use of dough conditioner and other additives. Preferments, on the other hand, naturally improve the dough texture, making it easier to work without resorting to additives. So, there are two basic types of preferments. One is yeast preferment, which is also called as yeast starters, and sourdough preferments, which is usually called as sourdough starters or natural starters. Sourdough starters are similar to yeast preferments, except that they are made with wild yeast. The starters are known as sour because of the acidity created in the dough during the long fermentation. This acidity affects not only the flavor of the bread, but also the texture. The starches and proteins are modified by the acids, resulting in a moister crumb and better keeping qualities. Let's discuss some of the yeast preferments. The first one is Polish, which is said to have originated in Poland, and the word Polish comes from polish. A Polish is a thin yeast starter made with equal parts of flour and water plus commercial yeast. So in other words, a formula for Polish is 100% flour, 100% water, and varying percentages of yeast depending on the desired speed of fermentation. To contribute maximum flavor, a Polish is made with only a small quantity of yeast and given a long fermentation at room temperature. Next is Biga, which is the Italian term for preferment. Although the word can, in theory, refer to a starter of any consistency, it is usually used for stiff preferments. Because stiffer doughs ferment more slowly than wet ones, a biga is generally made with more yeast. Usually, the quantity of yeast is used as twice as in a Polish to get the same fermentation time. The next is levain, which is a general French term for yeast preferment. It is usually stiff like biga, but the term is sometimes used for thin preferments like the Polish as well. And last is the scrap dough, which is simply a piece of fermented bread dough say from a previous batch. Saving a piece of fermented dough, preferably in the retarder, so it doesn't over ferment, is an easy and common way to get the benefits of using a pre-ferment without actually having to make one. Because scrap dough is actually bread dough, it differs from other ferments in that it contains salt as well as flour, water, and yeast. The salt slows the fermentation. To balance the salt, a scrap dough contains more yeast than the other types of pre-ferments. These are the references used for making this video. Thank you very much for watching the video. In the next part, we shall be discussing about the process of making an artisan bread using sourdough culture. Don't forget to watch that video. Thank you once again.